SOLIDWORKS makes life easier for sheet metal designers and fabricators with simple tools and a set of stock bend and gauge tables. But what if your tools start to wear and you need to update your values? Or you can't find the desired radius for your sheet thickness? Well, SOLIDWORKS lets you create completely customized gauge and bend tables to suit you and your specific tools. So, let's show you how to make them. SOLIDWORKS lets us work with gauge tables, bend tables, and a third hybrid type that combines both gauge and bend tables together into one document. These tables restrict sheet metal parts to particular thicknesses and bend allowances specified within these Excel documents. We've created a simple sheet metal part to illustrate how a gauge table works. By choosing our sample aluminium gauge table and a 10 gauge or 3 mm sheet thickness, our radius is now restricted to only values that appear in the gauge table for the relevant thickness, a range of 3 to 10 mm. The bend allowance in this case is still controlled by whichever factor you specify here. If you aren't clear on what each of the bend allowance types are, then check out our other video that explains exactly what each of them mean and do. But for now, let's customize this gauge table. The first thing we need to do is find the folder location where the default sheet metal tables are saved. The easiest way is to access the SOLIDWORKS system options and head to the File Locations tab before selecting sheet metal bend tables or gauge tables from the dropdown. By default, this will be set to the installation directory for SOLIDWORKS and includes the Excel spreadsheets for bend and gauge tables. This location can be customized, but we recommend leaving it as default and just copying any customized tables into this folder when you're finished. As these files are read-only, take a copy of the two folders to your local drive. These will act as templates for this tutorial. SOLIDWORKS takes the values from these Excel sheets and presents them in the Property Manager. Our table name is chosen from the dropdown, and the process is an informational value that's displayed below it. Gauge tables are the simplest form of sheet metal table, and only need three columns to function: the gauge number, the gauge thickness, and the available bend radius. The gauge number is what we select in the sheet metal parameters, and SOLIDWORKS uses that to reference the gauge thickness in the unit specified at the top of the sheet. Available radii are listed and separated by semicolons, which SOLIDWORKS uses to populate the radius dropdown. There are a couple of important things to note that can cause a gauge table to stop working. Firstly, make sure that the gauge thickness column header is not changed. It must read gauge thickness, otherwise the table will not work. And when you're writing out the list of gauges, make sure that you don't leave any gaps between them. If you do leave a gap, SOLIDWORKS will stop reading at it, and then anything after the gap will not be included in the drop-down list. It's good practice to order the gauge numbers by ascending or descending thicknesses to make it easier for users to find their desired values. Save and copy the file back into the sheet metal gauge table folder when you're done. Compared to gauge tables, bend tables are more complicated, as they reference values for bend allowances as well as radii and thicknesses. SOLIDWORKS will read the bend table when we choose bend table for our bend allowance and leave the gauge table box unticked. Our sheet metal parameters here will be entered manually, and when we OK this, SOLIDWORKS will bring up Excel very briefly to embed the bend table file into the part. That way, if we sent this file to someone else, the bend data will be preserved. Let's edit the local copy of a bend table. SOLIDWORKS reads the thickness we specified and pulls the associated bend data from the relevant table. It's worth noting that if you use a thickness that isn't included in the bend table, SOLIDWORKS will default to the K-factor value instead and let you know with an error message. On the other hand, if we choose a radius that doesn't feature in the table, then SOLIDWORKS will interpolate between the nearest values to give the accurate bend data. Formatting is extremely important for bend tables to work properly. Firstly, make sure your units are accurate, and specify what the bend allowance is based on. Then the thickness values need to be in ascending order. Any values out of order will prevent SOLIDWORKS from reading the table. The radius values must also match all the way down the Excel sheet, regardless of whether or not they're appropriate for your sheet thickness. These can be left blank, but must at least be included in the column headers. So in our case, the only radius value that can be present in column B is 1 mm. Otherwise, you'll be greeted with an error that states that the bend table is not valid. When specifying multiple tables within a sheet, there must be a maximum of 10 empty lines between the tables. 2 blank lines should be enough for readability. Just keep these consistent between tables. Add in the values you need for each thickness, radius, and bend angle. Then save the file and copy the customized table back into the sheet metal bend tables folder. Now, before we dive into the best recommendation for sheet metal tables, be sure to check out our dedicated SOLIDWORKS sheet metal training course. There you can learn all the fundamental tools and techniques to generate accurate flat patterns, speed up your workflow, and convert files into sheet metal parts rapidly. Visit our website to book your place today, or inquire about the SOLIDWORKS training passport to learn from the SOLIDWORKS experts alongside other industry professionals in a classroom or virtual environment. The final sheet metal table option is the most commonly recommended use of bend tables, and it's the hybrid gauge and bend table. These look relatively similar to bend tables, but we also have the gauge number in these tables as well. With the hybrid table, we can select the use gauge table option, choosing our desired table from the list. This table gives us the option to specify both the thickness and the bend radius, but now the bend allowance defaults to the gauge table to restrict values to those in this table. When we were only using a bend table, we could manually specify the thickness, which could be out of the range of the Excel sheet. Instead, by using the hybrid gauge and bend table, we're restricted to thicknesses that have bend allowances associated with them. And the formatting is less important in a hybrid table. The column headers don't have to be in line or present for each thickness, so these tables can be a little neater. They also ensure that our bend allowance doesn't revert to the K factor, as it will only use the values set out in the sheet. These hybrid tables ensure that only available thicknesses are used, and that the most accurate flat pattern is obtained. Again, once you've measured your tools and input the values for each radius, save the file and copy it back into that sheet metal gauge tables folder. Generally, we recommend using the hybrid gauge and bend table, as they take the process from both the gauge and the bend table and protect you against incorrect or invalid thicknesses and bends. Make sure you keep your documents up to date whenever you're auditing or measuring your tools, or request the data from your manufacturer to ensure that your designs are as accurate as they can be. Sheet metal fabrication is just one of the manufacturing disciplines that we support at Solid Solutions. So be sure to check out our inspection, CAM, and woodworking tools and services that can integrate seamlessly with SOLIDWORKS. Get in touch with us via the details on screen to discover how we can help you to streamline your design process and get your products to market faster.